Do you like the hire for your boy?
I'm not going to say whether I like it or not because I honestly don't know because I don't know much about this guy. What I'm going to say is this. Somebody help me understand. Boy, is it good to see you today, Ron Clark. Because and you know what, Max? Damn it, it's good to see you too. Always good to see you, Mom. Here's the deal. I am lost. I am lost. It's somebody's. Listen, Matt LaFleur, whoever you are, congratulations. Nothing but the best to you, 39 years of age. Yeah. We got it. You were an offensive coordinator, even though you were supposed to be the offensive coordinator in L.A. with the Rams last year. Mm-hmm. But you left there. I guess Sean McVay was calling the plays. Obviously, you want to go someplace else to prove your muscle. I get all of that. Right. And I appreciate the fact that somebody new is in the mix, not the same old dudes coming through the row. All right, fine. New opportunity for you. I wish you nothing but the best. You lucked up. You got Aaron Rodgers as your quarterback. Here's where I'm lost. The Titans offense. This is who you are. The offensive coordinator that has been chosen to coach Aaron Rodgers. Aaron freaking Rodgers. Talent-wise, the best, as far as I'm concerned, that I've ever seen. The offensive coordinator that you hired had the 27th ranked offense, 25th in points, the 29th ranked passing attack. That's the guy you chose. What am I missing? Listen, again, Matt LaFleur, wherever you are, I'm not knocking him at all. Please, I don't know. I don't know. All I'm saying is this. How did this happen? I'm like, wait a minute. So I'm Aaron Rodgers. It's me. I'm Aaron Rodgers for y'all, man. I know it's hard to imagine. I'm Aaron Rodgers for the moment, Max. I'm Aaron Rodgers for the moment, Ryan.
I can see the resemblance.
I actually have a resemblance.
This is me. I'm flinging that football with no problem. I have a problem to the point where Mike McCarthy, who's a Super Bowl champion, who I went to the playoffs 8 straight years with, I don't want to listen to the point where he's sending in plays and I'm ignoring him. But your answer to the remedy to that is a guy who had the 29th ranked pass
attack. Can I ask a question and excuse my naivete? I might be totally
I also love that word, by the way.
Off base.
It is a beautiful word.
Thank you.
But
is there any way that he was consulted, that Aaron Rodgers, in terms of who they were bringing in, that he was a part of this decision where he could – no, I'm serious.
No, I'm serious.
They say they weren't going to involve Aaron Rodgers.
Let me answer that question. When people in Green Bay that I've spoken to over the last year and a half, they told me one time Aaron Rodgers, this is like 2-3 years ago, walked into the office. I don't know whether it was Ted Thompson or Mark Burris. I forgot who it was. And they told him, get the hell up out the office. You play, we run the franchise. So if you're treating him like that before, I mean, that's just 2-3 years ago.
I find it very hard to believe that he didn't have input here.
Well, they did fire the same franchise that fired his quarterback coach without even telling him.
That's true, but then they got rid of the coach that he wanted gone. Because you know, pressure busts pipes, maybe that's not the right expression, but the idea is like, or how about if there wasn't for the last minute, nothing would ever get done.
By the way, I say
so
20.
They see the horizons for him aren't as long anymore, right. And now they have pressure to get something done.
I say 29th, but let me just accentuate it. The third worst passing attack.
Look.
He's offensive coordinator.
Look.
And he got the job.
I don't know if it's the right hire or not either, but
right.
I will say it's the right resume. This is the resume you want to see from a hire. What you don't want to see is like what the Giants did. The Giants gave into kind of the worst impulses of conservatism. There are many good impulses of conservatism, but a bad impulse is this gives me the feeling of something I'm familiar with. Pat Shurmur is the kind of, Gettleman. These are the kind of, they're talking the talk that feels good to me because it sounds familiar.
It's comfortable.
That's comfortable. It's unthinking. This is a thinking man's hire. So why is that? He's the quarterback's coach for Matt Ryan when Matt Ryan wins the MVP and almost wins the Super Bowl. Mm-hmm. He is the offensive coordinator for Sean McVay when they turned that whole thing around running play action with Jared Goff and Todd Gurley when they got Whitworth at left tackle. Mm-hmm. You look at Nagy, you look at Shanahan, you look at McVay, look at the coaches who are having success. They're young, dynamic play callers who were offensive coordinators and they were forward-looking. That appears on resume, that appears to be what Aaron Rodgers is getting. And so based on the resume, it's the right kind of hire.
Yeah, like I feel you in that. Like when you look at the paper, right, when you hold the resume in front of you, you say, oh, he had Matt Ryan. Oh, he had Jared Goff in the year he turned it around. But what that paper doesn't say is you had Kyle Shanahan, right? The paper doesn't say you had Sean McVay. And so I'm also on the side of Stephen A. Like, watch the Tennessee Titans. It didn't look creative, right? And you speak about a forward-thinking hire. Mm-hmm. The offense didn't look forward-thinking. Marcus Mariota wasn't a revolution. This wasn't a revelation. This wasn't a guy who has the second overall pick of the draft, started to ascend to even be in the top two tiers of passing quarterback. On the other side of it, I say this. And people may disagree. When Mike Tomlin walked into the office of the Rooneys with his book and said, "You know what? I want to be the head coach. I want to put my hat in the race for the head coach of the Pittsburgh Steelers." He wasn't the favorite, right? He'd only been a coordinator for 1 year. He'd only ran a defense in Minnesota. So sometimes it's not necessarily about the X's and O's. And I think we get caught up in that because of Frank Reich. Right, because of Doug Peterson, because of Matt Nagy, the way that Sean McVay and these different guys have affected the offense from a play caller perspective. Sometimes it's the personality.
Sure.
Right. The John
with Tomlin, it was obvious.
Right. The John Harbaughs of the world, who was a special teams coach. Right. But he goes in, he blows you away in interviews, and you feel like his personality, the way that his character can lead a team. Sometimes that's even more important than what you can do from an X's and O's standpoint.
I'm not disagreeing, but I need help from both of y'all here. Work with me. Again, that's why we're not saying it's a bad hire.
For sure.
Because we don't know. But the points that you use, I'm looking at it and saying, well, that's reason for more trepidation, not less. If I have Sean McVay to lean on, then I'm looking at it and like that.
No,
you can look at it and say he's learning from
him. Let me flip that around.
Or you can say he's benefiting from him.
Yeah. That's always the question. These are unknowns. We shall find out, right? But time will tell. It always does. Right.